Good afternoon, one and all. Welcome to today biology session. Coming to 9th class biology. Apart from that 9th biology, till now we discuss about that cell its structure and functions, the first chapter. Second one, plant tissues. Third one, animal tissues. Now we are going to discuss about the fourth chapter, plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. See, actually, plasma membrane are also called as a cell membrane, which the membrane contains the lipids and proteins. It is also called as the selectively permeable membrane because of specific functions which is carried out by the plasma membrane. See, once again, plasma membrane also called as cell membrane. It is the outermost layer in the typical cell of animal, which is the outermost layer which provides the cell from the outer environment. It is the bridge between the outer and the inner medium, and it is having a specific structure and a specific function which gives the mechanical support to the cell. So this is the cell membrane. Already we studied in the 8th class itself, cell, the basic unit of life. Whereas coming to the continuation and extension part of this 8th chapter, cytology, means study of the cell, cytology or cell biology, next level, mean 9th class first chapter, cell its structure and functions. Apart from that, cell and cell organelles also we completed in that 9th class first chapter. So I mean that cell is the basic unit of life because of all the living organisms are made up of cells and their products like tissues, organs and organ systems. So these are all the concepts already well known and we have completed till now. So now let us take a typical plant cell or animal cell. Usually it consists of mainly three layers. Those are called as the cell membrane, outermost layer, cytoplasm, which is a fluid filled portion which is floating of the all the cell organelles within the cytoplasm. Nucleus is the it is the boss of the cell, which can control and coordinate all the cell activities within the cells. And seven cell organelles already we completed their structures and specific functions in that previous lessons. I mean that actually out of 11 chapters in the 9th biology, the first 4 chapters are correlated. I mean that cell, its structure and functions, and that is called as a cytology or cell biology. Second branch is histology, study of tissues is called as histology. So Linnaean group, even the term histology means a group of cells. Study of the group of cells are called as histology. So till now we discuss about only two branches in the biology, that is called as one is the first one is cytology and second one is histology. So I mean that these four lessons are integrated. Actually this lesson plasma membrane actually is not a separate chapter, because it is just one of the part of the first chapter, cell its structure and functions. Just it is one of the part of one of the labeling part of the cell. It is a typical cell or typical plant cell or animal cell. It is the one of the part of the cell. But we have to discuss in a detailed information about plasma membrane because of its own significance, because of its characteristic feature. We have to elaborate a separate chapter because of they are having the such a huge functions are carried out by this plasma membrane. So what are the duties which are carried out by plasma membrane or these cell membranes? See, first one is it is also called as a selectively permeable membrane. It can be selected which substances are required. So those should be allowed into the cell which are not essential, that should be sent outside. So get in and go out, which should be carried out by this selectively permeable membrane. That they are given in the list of the tabular form in that our textbook. Just we have to take the textbook and we can go through that the list of the duties which is carried out by the cell membrane or plasma membrane. See, actually activity number 1 we are given to that get in and go out. See, this is the activity number 1, get in and go out. They are given to that the substances, for example oxygen,
glucose, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, carbon dioxide and some other waste products. So actually these are the three types of materials. Oxygen is a gas state, glucose, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, these are called as solid states, and some of the enzymes and hormones and water, these are the liquid states, carbon dioxide is a gas state. Means the cell requires the three states of materials, obviously. So some are essential to that cell to function the metabolic activities. So for example, see, oxygen, glucose, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, these are very essential to that cell to perform the metabolic activities. So these should be allow them. So should go into the cell. Into the cell, these are the particles, these are the substances which are entered into the cell. Of course, carbon dioxide and waste should not enter into the cell because of it is called as a selectively permeable membrane. Next, should go out of the cell, means carbon dioxide eliminate from the cells, and it should be entered into the blood, carboxyhemoglobin, which collects to heart. The heart is pumping to the lungs, lungs will send out. This we will learn in the 10th class third chapter, transportation, in a very clear manner. Next, coming to that, some waste, for example, accumulation of these waste products, which forms the mainly nitrogenous based compounds, which are very dangerous to our body. So through regular intervals of the these filtration of the blood by the kidneys, the chief excretory products in our body, we are eliminating these waste materials, and also from the other secondary accessory metabolites like these skin, lungs. So these are the some accessory excretory organs in our body which can eliminate the waste materials. See children, so based on this tabular form, we can identify that, we can understand about that, the importance of cell membrane or plasma membrane, how it allows the materials inside and how it can be eliminated from the cell from to outside. So coming to that, based on the tabular form, they are going to ask some more questions. See, which substances should enter into the cell, why? Actually, some essential materials like this glucose, oxygen, these are very essential to cell to perform the metabolic activities like digestion, respiration, transportation, excretion. All these life process, certainly they require these food and solids and liquids and gas state. Next, which substances should come out of the cell, why? Actually, in this process of metabolic activities, some waste materials are produced. Some of the secondary metabolites, they are very poisonous to our body. So immediately we have to eliminate from our body, like for example, carbon dioxide and some other waste like nitrogen based compounds like ammonia, urea and uric acids. Next, can you name any other substances which should enter into the cell? Yes, apart from these oxygen, glucose, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, some other materials, for example, hormones or enzymes, these are also enter into our the cell. Enter into the cell. Next, which substances should enter into the cell and go out of the cells? Actually, the blood is entered into the cell. When it supplies to the oxygen to the two cells, it collects the carbon dioxide and go out of the cells. So the substances, these are entered into the cell. The substances which are go out of the cell is called as carbon dioxide and waste. So this is called as selectively permeable membrane. Based on the tabular form of activities performance, we concluded that plasma membrane or cell membrane is called as a selectively permeable membrane, which can carry out get in and go out. Thank you, children. Next, coming to understand about the preparing the solution, and we have to go on to that topic, preparing the solution. So let us concentrate on the board. We are going to continuation of that. What is meant by solution? See, till now we discuss about what you mean by cell membrane or plasma membrane as a part of the cell. It is the one of the basic main part of the cell. Next, coming to the functions which is carried out by cell membrane or plasma membrane is called as a get in and go out. Next, the plasma membrane or selectively permeable membrane or cell membrane, which is carried out mainly two functions. One is a diffusion and the second one is osmosis. Diffusion occurs in that only
the solid and the gaseous, the liquid state and the gaseous state. Whereas coming to the osmosis occurs in the liquid state. So diffusion occurs in the solid, liquid and gaseous state. So this osmosis diffusion, so before coming to these two terms, which is the very essential processes of carried out by the cell, first better to understand what you mean by solution and how to prepare the solution. So solution in the sense, for example, we have a different kinds of solution, salt solution, sugar solution, so we have decoction, so we are having the different kinds of solution. Solution means obviously we are having the two components, one is the solvent, the second one is the solute. So what is meant by solvent? For example, we are adding some sodium chloride, means salt, to that adding to water is called as a salt solution. Here water is the solvent. Water is the solvent, means it can be dissolved the substances. So solute means the particular component which is dissolved in that water is called as a solute. So the combination of solute and solvent make a solution. For example, NaCl solution, sodium chloride solution or salt solution. So based on the concentration of this solute, the solutions are mainly three kinds. Those are called as hypertonic solution. Hypertonic solution means high concentration solution. Next one is hypotonic solution, means low concentration, diluted solution. This is concentrated solution, this is a diluted solution. This is called as isotonic solution. Isotonic means both the mediums, I mean that both the solute and solvent are having the same concentration. That is called as isotonic solution. See, how to prepare the concentrated solution? We have to take an example. Take a beaker and fill with 100 ml of water. And we are adding, for example, 2 tablespoons of sugar. Certainly it should be dissolved in the 100 ml of water. If we are adding still, for example, after 10th spoon, 11th spoon of sugar we are adding, that time it should not be dissolved and it should be settled down in the bottom of the beaker. So I mean that the total solution is completely dissolving the sugar particulate. So it should not be dissolved still more. So that this is called as 100% saturated solution, means satisfied, should not be dissolving some more. So this is called as a saturated solution or concentrated solution. For example, let us take second example, hypotonic solution, means unsaturated. Same example, 100 ml of water, just we are adding 10 grams or 20 grams of sugar into that solution, or 10 grams or 20 grams of salt in that this water, it can be dissolved easily. So still more it should be dissolving. So such kind of solution is called as unsaturated solution or diluted solution. Diluted solution. For example, what do you mean by 10% of solution? For example, 90 ml of water, 90 ml of water and 10 ml, I mean that 10% or 10 ml of this NaCl added Na plus Cl minus. So this sodium chloride is called as 9 ml of water plus 10 or 10 ml of 10 ml of 10% means 10 ml of sodium chloride is called as 10% sodium chloride solution. Sodium chloride solution means this is called as a diluted solution. For example, here this is called as a diluted NaCl solution. Diluted NaCl solution. Let us take another example. For example, concentrated solution means 90% or 90 ml of sodium chloride. Only just 10 ml of water we are adding. So this is called as a This is called as 90% NaCl solution. NaCl solution. This is called as a concentrated solution. So this is the way to prepare the solutions of hypertonic and hypotonic solutions. Next, isotonic means equivalent concentration. 50 ml of water, we are adding the 50 grams of sugar or sodium chloride. These concentration are both are equal. This is called as a isotonic solution. See children. Now once again we can recall the concept of what we have to learn till now. Plasma membrane, actually it is not a separate chapter, but based on the importance of this plasma membrane or cell membrane, which is obviously made up of lipids and proteins, and which can act like a selectively permeable membrane. It can be select and sent inside and go outside. So based on the activity, the cell can perform the different kinds of metabolic activities like digestion, respiration, transportation. Obviously, they require the, some of the substances like in the form of solids, liquids and gases. So, they should be transported from one cell to another cell by the two methods. One is the diffusion and the osmosis. Diffusion in the sense of transportation of the materials from the higher concentration to lower concentration. Just we have to apply the perfume. So, obviously the perfume bottle is having a high concentration of the solution which can be spreading, which can be spread out easily through lower concentration of the concentration. So the way the molecules which are transferred to the higher to lower lesions are called as the diffusion process. Diffusion process. Like agarbattis or perfumes, recently LG polymers, that is sterile gases, Bhopal, methyl isocyanate is a tragedy of unforgettable tragedy in that Bhopal. So all the incidents, these are called as a diffusion process. Let us come to that, what is meant by osmosis. Osmosis means, actually it is a Greek word which means to push or pulling. So osmosis means here lower concentration to higher concentration. Lower to higher concentration, but certainly they require the plasma membrane. So one cell to another cell. For example, this is another cell. How the nutrients like the glucose and the amino acids or the hormones or the enzymes, they are transported to one cell to another cell through the plasma membrane. So plasma membrane is a selectively permeable membrane. It can be allow them to the substance to the other cell by the osmosis process. This is called as a plasma membrane. Obviously here the low concentration which is already used up, this is a higher concentration. So low to high through selectively permeable membrane or like the plasma membrane is called as osmosis. For example, let us take how the ground level water should reaches to the top of the bottom, from bottom to top of the plant. See, for example, this is a plant, obviously these are the roots. So roots are having the root hairs, these are the soil particles. So the water which is present in the soil particles that should be collected from the root hairs. So here the water content is a low concentration when compared with the root hair cells. For example, this is the root hair cells. Obviously the root hair cells are having the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm concentration is more because of they are having the sugar content or glucose content in the cytoplasm. This is called as a normal water, means plain water, low concentration. So from low concentration to high concentration through plant cell membrane, so it allows them into inside of the path. So this is called as a root hair transportation of water or mineral salts from lower concentration to higher concentration. So here root present and it goes to the top, which is the top of the leaf. So this is the way how the water is transported in the plants. So all these concept extension part we can learn in the 10th class transportation or the circulatory system, which is the plant physiology and animal physiology, we can learn in the 10th class level. So in this video, just we are going to concentrate on that what is meant by plasma membrane. What are the main functions which is carried out by plasma membrane, like diffusion and osmosis. Of course, other duties and the functions already we completed in the first chapter, cellular structure and functions. So this slide we are going to learn about what is meant by solution, what is meant by hypertonic, hypotonic and isotonic solution. That is coming to that one. Water is actually is called as a universal solvent. I mean that the majority of the substances, just like exemption like camphor or some naphthalene, only benzene, like this, some of the only some elements which are not dissolved in the water. Majority 90% of the elements which can dissolve in the water, so that water is a universal solvent. So this is the way to the preparation of the solution. Thank you children, we will continue that next video.